Well, with allegations of fraud circulating around an investment company claiming to sell Bitcoin.
If it sounds too good to be true, it might actually not be true.
While scores of residents have reportedly invested thousands of dollars in a company now facing allegations of fraud, what should you look out for? Be wary of companies that guarantee high returns.
Well, a Ponzi scheme is basically a pyramiding scheme where the early investors into the scheme are tempted by promises of very high rates of return. They begin to receive fairly high returns on their investments, or they are convinced that they are receiving high returns on their investment.
This is because any new investors that join the group are often contributing to the pay of the first investors. The first group of individuals are then led to believe that they're making a profit, when in fact, they're not.
Ponzi scheme is fraud. Find out everything they can about the security, the sellers of the security, where the income from that investment is supposed to derive.
And people saying, well, they haven't shown this, they haven't shown that. Well, their accounts aren't even due yet. You know, what business do you know, any business, that does their accounts early?
Where the income from that investment is supposed to derive. The income from that investment is supposed to derive.
Derp, 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 derp.
Being careful and, like I say, doing your homework, finding out how this investment works rather than just relying upon a sales pitch.
Reporting for PNC News, I'm Rebecca Elmore.
Hi, everyone.
This is James.
This is James Lockett.
This is James.
I wanted to give you an update on Global Moneyline. From Global 1-to-1, on behalf of my wife, Grace, and I, we'd like to welcome you back to Global 1-to-1. Hi, everyone. It's Grace and James. How are you doing?
Hello, everyone.
We love Bitcoin.
Bitcoin.
Yeah, we love our Bitcoins.
Bitcoin.
Yeah.
And I'm going to address the U.S. and Canada situation, and none of us are very happy today. There was a major action taken today with respect to operations in the United States. Go over the notice itself.
This is a press release.
All right, so it reads, you're a customer, dear customer. Actually, maybe I'm not going to read it. I'll just try to summarize it. What we learned is that there's been an official action, but also what we did not know before, a court-ordered preliminary injunction.
This is a press release
that has been placed against the company. They do specifically mention a court order, and I don't know the background of that court order.
A goodbye, we're leaving you, skiddly-dum. A goodbye, we wish you fond goodbye. Fart a totter, a fart a lotter. A goodbye, we're leaving you, skiddly-dum. A goodbye, we wish you fond goodbye. Fart a totter, totter.
Loud, because...
Yeah.
Seems that it's promotion or advertising of a security that is problematic. They also say that you need to take down all marketing pages, social media, to the sale of USI Tech goods. USI Tech is taking our money and running.
Yeah.
Is James going to do a sex class for you today? We're talking about how to arouse.
Arouse.
I never touched network marketing or direct sales at all. And he was always trying to pull me in that business, but it was no way. I mean, if you are in a responsible management position, you cannot participate in network marketing companies at all.
I'm here representing Huawei Technologies. We're one of the world's largest telecoms equipment operators. We serve 45 of the 50 largest telecom operators in the world.
If you are in a responsible management position, you cannot participate in network marketing companies at all.
So today, guys, what I wanted to talk to you about was some of the different techniques and things that are used in the online and business opportunity world in general. The first thing that they do, and it's one of the most important, is that they attack your identity.
Hi, I'm going to give you the truth about residual income. And you for sure don't know that you really desperately need it because your financial situation sucks.
They also try to get you into their community, get you to go to their events, and all these things that tie you to the group so that even if you have questions, you really don't want to leave without losing your new family.
So if you want to be a top earner, you have to look like a top earner. You've got to go to company events and show up at the conference calls and show up at the meetings. If you want to really be a top earner, you will only become a top earner, get this one, when you can bring 100 people to your company event. If you can bring 100 people out of all the people that you have in your organization, if you can bring 100 people to your next company event, that means you've really got a substantial system.
The final step is they try to get you to have a feeling of rebirth, that you're a new person, that you've gone through this event, you've gone through all of the elements, you come out of it a brand new person.
Hi guys, this is James Lockett from Global One to One. We will send to you 7 days of success. I want to talk to you about Think and Grow Rich.
And if you look at the numbers for almost all these business opportunities out there, almost everybody is losing money and not making money. And these techniques, these brainwashing and cult techniques, are the very things that keep people in as long as possible and get as much money as possible from you to keep this scheme going and keep the runners, the people that actually are these great leaders, keep them very wealthy.
The money you want in your life is living in the pockets of the people who you have not yet contacted.
I'd walk up to the guy, avoid eye contact, step to the side, look him in the eye, and then I'd be gone.
Still there.
But the money's gone. You see, I took the wallet the first time, then put it back the second, only without the money.
The money you want in your life is living in the pockets.
Living in the pockets.
Living in the pockets of the people you have not yet contacted.
One of the deceptions that's used to get people to join an MLM scam is the myth of long-term residual income generated by recruiting people for 3 to 5 years into the scam.
Residual income is the type of income that comes in regularly. You know, whether it's weekly or monthly, it's automatic. It comes in with you doing nothing. And then money comes in on a continual, steady basis afterwards.
The idea that you can work for a few years and then never have to work again is a powerful motivation to join. Here's an example of this deception in action. One residual income idea is network marketing. Network marketing has received a negative reputation throughout the years, mainly because of a high failure rate. That's due to the fact that people who enter the profession don't take their business serious or don't know the first thing about marketing.
Hi everyone, if you could get advice from a seven-figure earner who advises dozens of other seven and eight and six-figure earners on how to become a top earner, do you think you would listen?
However, if done properly, it can produce incredible riches. In fact, there are more millionaires made in network marketing profession than any other business industry in the world.
Grace and I have already become, you know, kind of low-level six-figure earners.
And it's endorsed by moguls such as Donald Trump, Warren Buffett, and Robert Kiyosaki. Finding a vehicle that will produce residual income will get you on the right track to become financially free and creating long-term wealth for you and your family.
The Invest, Learn, Teach, ILT system. I thought I would pick this beautiful location, very peaceful, to talk to you about all the crazy storm about USI Tech, the ridiculous nonsense that is out there on social media right now about USI Tech and mining.
Founder Ralph running down the aisle.
And all kinds of
silly people saying that USI Tech are liars and scammers.
USI!
And whatsoever. And they actually have no idea whatsoever what they are talking about. Or they are haters.
Was it a scam all the time?
So what are we talking about? We're talking about the big debate that came out since Ralph Gold, who announced that he would be going to Iceland to look at USI Tech's new mining facility in Iceland.
Founder Ralph running down the aisles.
And to give us a video to show it to us.
Charles Xavier. Mr. Charles Xavier, also known as Your Daily Abundance on YouTube.
When you shine light on the evil, the darkness, it lashes out. It's angry. Which is why I want to share a little video. This guy's name is James, and he has a long history with multi-level marketing schemes and scams, and ones have that have also imploded.
Charles Xavier, Your Daily Abundance, top-level promoter of Ponzi Scheme USI Tech.
But I hit a nerve with this guy, and he is not happy.
Here's the two key things that you need to know about transparency. And there's only two things that anybody needs to know. And the rest of it is commercial secrets.
Super secret.
So USI Tech is under no obligation to some idiot Twitter, nor to some idiot Facebooker to tell where USI Tech has contracts with, who those contracts are with, what are the terms. Even had somebody demanding to know the Bitcoin account that USI Tech makes payments to for its mining.
The income from that investment is supposed to derive.
Derp, 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 derp.
Really? That fool? Come on.
Claiming their Genesis mining agreement was null and void, it was false, which Genesis Mining said themselves. We don't know how that video happened of the guy running through showing you the mining equipment, Mr. Ralph Gold or whatever. Founder Ralph running down the aisle.
Bitcoin promoter, USI Tech, hit with emergency order. What is this? How could this be? This is a legit company. They've got a mining pool all of a sudden, or did they pay somebody? We got to pretend that we have something that we don't have. They finally got a mining pool. Information about whether the company's financial condition is strong enough to provide a 1% daily return. All things that they will not provide anybody.
The income from that investment is supposed to derive.
Furthermore, the sales agents are attempting to deceive the public by claiming that USI Tech has a binding legal opinion from a law firm stating that the company is a legal business in good standing. Anybody in USI Tech, get your effing money out of there. Don't roll it back in. New packages. When these guys get nailed, he'll be going to jail. That man will be going to jail.
You know who I'm talking about. I'm not going to name names, but he likes to do this. So you know who I'm talking about.
Charles Xavier loves when I do this. Ponzi scheme. But they finally got a mining pool.
Perfect. Round two. Fight.
Ponzi scheme. But they finally got a mining pool. But they finally got a mining pool.
Perfect.
With a bullet.